brought up on these outer islands. It took me a long time to realise how important it is to live here. We've been living on this island over 40 years. When I was a young child, and I used to look forward to every year going up on the hills and watching all the humpbacks jump out of the water. And that was really exciting, just like yesterday. And when they had the whaling here, destroyed all that. Lots of things that you've seen years ago, that some of those things are not there anymore when it comes to our kaitiaki. And we're here wanting to do something about that.
Tū Mai Taonga is a mana whenua-led project on Aotea Great Barrier Island. It's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for our whānau to lead conservation at a landscape scale. Our whānau harbour a deep sense of whakamā, or shame, for things that we've lost. Our language, our culture, the health of the environment. And we feel a deep sense of responsibility to reclaim what we can. We are looking to remove all feral cats and rats from Aotea, and that is very ambitious. We've been building relationships with our funding partners, Predator Free 2050 Limited, the Department of Conservation and Auckland Council help us to achieve our audacious goal to be predator free on Aotea. Tū Mai Taonga means stand forth treasure, and the goal of the project is to make a way for taonga species to thrive again.
Brother always has a saying, ocean's our fridge, bush is our freezer. Don't look after them, going to have anything. It's good to see the young fellows getting into it, actually wanting to do it, rather than just turning up for work every day and getting paid. I pretty much walk from one end of the island to the other. When I'm too old to walk these hills, I don't hope that's any time soon. I hope my kids come back and carry on too.
Our hapū has been able to create not only jobs and training opportunities, but real and long-lasting career pathways for our whānau. We have over 30 workers on the project, more than half of them are mana whenua, and many of those have been able to return home and re-establish here. Because this project is ambitious and complex, we use advanced technology. Remote monitoring in our feral cat trapping network cuts down our trapping hours by 90% or more. So that's game-changing technology.
My role is to protect and preserve our history on the island. Our kaumātua chose me for the job. Preserving these places is important to us, so we know who we are, where we come from, connecting our people back to the land. Walking in around these wahitapu areas is a feeling of respect. We don't want the workers to break any tapu, to disrespect the area that they're working in and around. It's the whole reason for me going in, and so we can find these areas and avoid them. This area was used for harvesting of pigeons, growing of kumara, seasonal fishing. It was a thriving ecosystem. It's broken at the moment. Hoping in the future that we get to hear our bird songs that we used to, and see the birds that are dramatically in decline right now.
I've always loved the bush, being from Tūhoe, Ujinota Miss. Yeah, I just really appreciate the way that I've been acknowledged with this group of people on the island. Coming from a field worker and then coming into a team lead position, I had to adjust. I've never been in a role where I've had to tell people what to do and they have to listen. I've really come a long way in stepping into this role. Just being with my other field team leads, they have given me the courage to push me forward to be a better team lead and a better role model during work and after work. Yeah, I love it too. Love my job.
I moved to Australia when I was 3, stayed until I was 47. Then my father started getting unwell, so I moved home. And then I seen the opportunities and the conversations happening about Tū Mai Taonga. I jumped on it, and I'm glad I did. It's been a long time for me that we've been able to sit all of our whānau together, and for us to be able to all agree on this project, to me, that's a breakthrough. We're hearing our boys with 5-year goals, and that's something special, I think. Our young boys be able to build their own home. Landowners, homeowners, I can see them wanting more for themselves and for their families and for us all. It's a big one for me.
A year ago, I was rolling with a crowd that wasn't me. Tū Mai Taonga changed my life. So I'm out there working, I'm out there doing exercise. It's been special to me when I work up in these mangas. The thought that all my family have walked these hills, my tūpuna, seeing my mum walk these mountains, yeah, it's massive. Yeah, definitely proud of my mum. Being one of the youngest, it does help having the older boys mentor me and teach me all their little things they know. It makes the job a lot easier. Big goals for what I want to do in the next 5 years of my life.
Through the Tū Mai Taonga Project, our whānau are healing, are hopeful again, that we can achieve something long-lasting and important and necessary. We have full confidence that this project can succeed because we have the passion to make sure that it does. This project is enabling our whānau to press forward with hope, to reclaim our place, to reclaim who we are, and to be strong and proud of being Ngāti Rehua Ngātiwai ki Aotea.
O te pūtō ke toke o te tairongo, te pūtō ke toke o te wairongo, a tō ke toke o nukutō ke toke o rangi hommai te waiora ki a hau.